Welcome back to Design Bundle's YouTube channel. If you guys are new here, my name is Crystal. Today, we're gonna test out, can you sublimate wood? So this is whether you have like a little wood round like this, or even maybe a piece of wood that you have cut at the house. Can you sublimate it? We're gonna go ahead and put it to the test. We're gonna sublimate this one right here with nothing on it. And then we're also going to sublimate these two here with these two products. If you guys are familiar with Poly Tea Spray, that same company also makes a coating that you can coat your wood, glass, ceramic, all sorts of different things to be able to sublimate on. She has a natural as well as a gloss. So if you want something that looks like rustic, you could definitely go with a natural. And if you want something that has a gloss shine, you can go with this. Now, the gloss is made more geared toward, you know, coffee mugs, ceramic, things like that, but you can definitely still coat it on the wood to get that high sheen. So let's go ahead and put it to the test. I've already printed out my design 3 times using my Sawgrass printer, same design. So what we're gonna do is I'm going to sublimate this one here. There's nothing on it, like I said, just a plain wood round. I have my press at 300 degrees. I'm gonna go ahead and test this just to see if my pressure is good, which it definitely feels like it is. So we are gonna go ahead and tape this down. I could definitely use my Pro Spray for this or some tape. I'm just gonna tape it down. Now, one thing I wanna tell you guys right away, if this is something that you guys want to do after we test it out and any of these work, I want you to keep in mind, you could take your wood here, you could take some chalk paint, paint this, and then apply these coatings right here. And that way you have that white background or a light pink, you know, light colors. So that way your design pops off of it. So today it's probably not gonna really pop off this color, but just in case you guys want to do it and it works with these, I would recommend doing a chalk paint. And if that's something that you guys wanna see after all of this, if it works, let me know and we will definitely do it again. All right, so I've got this tape down. Let's go ahead and put some parchment paper to protect our press. All right, so we've got one on the press. I'm gonna have this face up and then we are going to cover it again. We have it at 400 degrees for 60 seconds. So that's what you normally would sublimate with. So we're just gonna put it to the test and see if we can actually sublimate on wood. Because we may be able to, it may come in, you know, super light, or it may actually work. Because think about it, wood is not something that we wash. So if it does work, we could coat it with things like a high sheen spray that's a, you know, like a clear coat, if you will. You could put epoxy over it and things like that to make it last in the weather. So fingers crossed, let's see what happens. I've never personally sublimated straight on wood, so we're gonna find out together. All right, so we are getting close to the end. We're about to find out. Now, one thing to keep in mind with this thin wood, it may want to try to warp, so I'm not too sure what's going to happen with that. All right, so let's pop this up. But you could do a thicker piece of wood with this as well if this coating works. Let's see. I'm going to pull it out so we can see it together. I'm going to go ahead and get my heat gloves here because this is definitely on the hot side. So let's go ahead and get our gloves. And the moment of truth, did it sublimate? Push pause, stop, let me know in the comments below, what do you think? Is it going to work or not? All right, here we go. Let's peel it. It worked. So you can definitely sublimate on wood without any sort of coating, as you guys can see here. Now, if you guys want me to put this to the test even further, I can definitely, you know, get different types of wood and we can test it out so you guys know before you start your project whether it's truly going to work or not. Now, let's take a look at it. It definitely is on the lighter side, but if we added, you know, some sort of clear coat over this, it's gonna make it a little bit more vibrant. Now, the one thing that I talked about too is putting a little bit of paint. I wouldn't do it with this because then you're gonna try to sublimate on that paint and possibly it's just gonna become a mess. We can definitely put it to the test if that's something you guys want to see. But as you guys can see here, it came out super nice. I mean, it is light, but I already expected that with the wood. So let's go ahead and coat our wood with the natural as well as the gloss. And let's just see what results we get compared to sublimating on wood. Now, the way that both of these products work here is it is 1 ounce to 1 milliliter of this dye press catalyst. So you have to have this as well. So what we're gonna do is I've got a couple medicine cups here and then I've got a syringe and things like that for this. So it's almost kind of similar to an epoxy And we're just going to put it to the test. Let's see what we got. We got a couple stir sticks here. I don't know why I'm still wearing my gloves. We're going to go ahead and pull those off and get ready to go. So let's start off with the Polynatural. So I'm going to go ahead and make sure I get enough in here to cover this. And apparently you only want one thin coat and you do not want to go over it with a second coat. So one thin coat is all it's going to take. You're going to let it dry for around 2 hours or so, and then you can let it finish drying in an oven or your heat press. You can press it for around 340 degrees for around 10 to 12 seconds. All right, so let's go ahead and I'm going to go ahead and just shake this just to make sure. I'm not going to shake it per se, but I'm going to go ahead and do some tilting action just to make sure. I've never used it before, just to make sure everything is good. So we are going to do, let's go ahead and take a look here. I'm going to do 15 mils. Now remember, 1 ounce to 1 mil. So since this is a half, I'm going to do a half mil here. So I'm going to go ahead and pull that up here. All right. And then I'm going to go ahead and get that in there just like so. From here, we're just going to go ahead and take our stir stick until it's well incorporated. I'm going to take me a piece of parchment paper to protect my surface here. And then we're just going to go ahead and take some of this here and we are going to coat this. Remember, it is a nice thin coat. So I'm just going to go over this. Now, according to the instructions, this is good for 18 hours. After that, you can reactivate it, adding some more of the catalyst. So I'm going to go ahead and go all the way over this. So if I had something with a lid, I could definitely seal that so I could reuse it later. So as you guys can see, this is such a big bottle, it would really last a long way. All right, I'm gonna set this one aside. As you guys can see, that is a lot. So I really would consider, I could have done like a quarter of this, unless I was gonna do several of these at the same time. Definitely feel free to mix that up. So I'm gonna go ahead and set this one out of the way and let's go ahead and mix up the next one. It's the exact same way. So we'll be back once these are drying down and we'll get ready to press them. Now that both of these have completely dried down, this is the natural, this is the gloss side. What we need to do is press these for around 10 seconds. So I'm gonna go ahead and place a parchment paper and then we're gonna press. Make sure before you start this project that you guys have already adjusted your pressure. All right, so once we've pressed that for 10 seconds, we are ready to add on our design. So what we're gonna do this one first and then I'll pre-press that one, is I'm going to lay this right on top of my design here, and then I'm going to tape it down. So remember, we are working with that natural. This is more of, you know, a rustic effect or whatever. All right, so now that we have this taped down, I'm gonna get it on here, and then we're gonna cover it with another parchment. Now this time we're gonna press it 400 degrees for 60 seconds. I'm gonna pop on my heat gloves again, pop this open. Go ahead and get those gloves ready to go because it was quite hot last time. So I'm gonna go ahead and remove this and let's see how it did. All right, moment of truth here. We're gonna go ahead and peel it back. So you guys can see with that natural, look at how much more vibrant this is. So remember how in the beginning we pressed the wood and it was like, it did sublimate. No, it didn't sublimate. This is sublimation. So you guys can see here how nice that looks compared to this one. So you guys can see how much better this looks. And this is even with that natural. So I'm really surprised to see how will the gloss look compared. So highly recommend so far. I definitely want to say maybe we can't sublimate on wood compared to this. All right, so let's set that one out of the way and let's try the gloss. All right, so we need to press this one for 10 seconds first. All right. We're gonna go ahead and do that press. You could definitely do all of this ahead of a time and you don't need to press it at 400 degrees like I am. You only need the 10 seconds. You're gonna do it around 340 for 10 seconds. So you could do all of your blanks first and then come back, or if you're just doing one project and then press, but you could do it at the same time. So I'm gonna go ahead and get ready to press our next one. And I'm gonna be honest with you guys, it did not take me 2 hours to let this set aside. After I brush this on, I just set it up here under my heat. So with a clamshell, if you had a swing away, you could let it hover and it dried in like 2 seconds. So I didn't even let it set for 2 hours. So I'm gonna go ahead and put this with the coating side down on our sublimation. And then I could take my gloves back off. Let's go ahead and get us some heat tape here. I am so excited about this, and I'm going to be honest with you guys. I've actually had it for maybe like 2 years. I just haven't had a chance to play with it. So it does have a quite a while of a shelf life. So you guys can see this container is going to last you a very long time. Let's go ahead and load this one. Press it. 400 degrees for 60 seconds. While we're waiting on this one, let's take another look. This is with the natural. I am definitely shocked. I thought, okay, it's sublimated. This is super, super light. So I'm going to say we can't sublimate wood because with this coating, wow, I am blown away. This is super cool. This means possibilities are endless. You could take a nice piece of wood that you have cut at the house, maybe from an old tree, let it dry out, cover this. Possibilities are endless, like I said. All right, so we are getting close. I'm going to pop back on these gloves again, because these sure are hot. And this is going to be with the gloss. All right, pop it open and let's see what it came out like. All right, so let's see what we got. Moment of truth here, so let's go ahead and peel. Wow, so I'm gonna say that we got about the same look as the other one. Once again, the gloss is more made for glass, so like your ceramic mugs and things like that. But I definitely say for the wood, I do like the natural better. You guys be the judge. Gloss is on the right, the natural is on the left. I'm gonna have a link down below for you guys so you guys can check this stuff out. I got these wood rounds from my local craft store, and I think it's like a pack of six. So I still even have more of these for less than $5. These would be great to add on your Christmas wreaths. You can make big ornaments if you wanted to. The wood ornaments that we've done in the past, you could definitely do those as well. I'm gonna go ahead and pop off these gloves really quick so we can really check them out. So I definitely think the colors are very comparable, but for the wood, I definitely like the natural. I almost think it came in a little bit darker, and you guys can see that was a super thin coat. And for both of these, I don't know if you guys can see inside here or not, completely full. So where I filled that line, it took absolutely nothing. So you guys could create little plaques with wood that you have. Like I said, you could do all sorts of different things. You guys can definitely sublimate on wood if you have yourself some poly. Once again, to recap, 100% you can sublimate on wood. It's not going to come out super bright and vibrant, but if you definitely want to sublimate any sort of wood that you have, definitely try out this poly. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you guys found it helpful. If you did, please hit the like button down below and subscribe, and I'll see you guys on the next one.